Here we go. Let's ride.
Hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes and International Cuisine, should I put it. You'll see in the slideshow that'll be coming up in a week or so. Today we're going to make some Mediterranean burgers, also known as Kaftas, Keftas, Koftas. And traditionally, they're made like a kebab, which is kind of a pain because you're dealing with a hamburger patty, basically. So I'm just going to make hamburger patties rather than trying to put them on kebabs, skewers, and turn them. It'll just be easier, and they eat just the same. You can eat them on a hamburger bun, on pita bread, on flour tortilla, just eat them, they good. And I may make a rice pilaf, homemade from scratch. It's easy to make. And what else? A salad, something. Have some hummus on the side with it. It's real good. It's good for you too, because it got garlic in it. And so do these burgers. They're loaded with garlic and grated onion and parsley. You could use cilantro. I've seen recipes both ways. So we get started building this. And I had to stop one of my favorite movies. Guess what it is? To make this for you fine people. So first off, I got some some really sexy looking garlic toes and an onion that's bleeding. It bleed white. Must be alien. Okay. I got some curly leaf parsley, and parsley stems, unlike cilantro, yeah, them kind, can be bitter. The cilantroed skins. The cilantro sticks, yeah, actually have a lot of flavor in them, more so than the leaves do. But parsley, you want to kind of pick through some of these because they are bitter, especially the bigger ones, which these don't really have a lot of. So anyway, wrench your parsley. I'm cracking up on the parsley. I don't know. Must be the pops. Hey, you see, get them big ones out of there. You don't want that. So I'll finish with that in a minute. And I got an onion. Like I said, it's bleeding. And we're going to grate it. And we're going to start crying. Because the fumes, they're getting your sinuses is what they do. And that irritates your eyes. So let's grate this onion up. Look, grate over here, camera boy. So grate the onion up. And we're gonna put that in that grind meat. Try not to get no knuckle meat in there, because you'd be pissed off to the highest level of pissivity. And that shit getting in my eye. It's getting in my little eye. Them fumes is, yeah, boy. Let me finish with that. All right. So I done grated a good bit of that onion until I couldn't see no more, because my eyes watered all up. And I got most of the sticks and seeds and stems out of there. And you want that liquid in that burger. Meat. Now, you can use a pizza cutter to grind this up. One of them Whopper Choppers. Oh Lord, look at this sumbitch coming all apart. Or one of these here. It's like a bunch of little pizza strip cutters all in one. And it do a better job than a single bladed pizza cutter. It's made for this, in other words. So whack these up. And these ain't gonna make you cry. I tell you what make you cry worse than that onion is go get you some hot sauce and rub your eyes with that. Or better yet, peel a jalapeno and then touch sensitive areas. You ain't gotta do it no more. If you do, you're just gonna have to stay stupid. Now, this is like building nuclear submarines down here. We got that grind up, and we're going to press these garlic toes, and you can put as much garlic and onion in here as you want. I got 1 pound of ground meat. That'll be plenty. We're going to put some, fresh ground cracked black pepper. And I got some Himalayan pink sea salt in there. No, and it's mountain salt. That's what it is. From the Himalayas. Let's press these toes here. Get in that toe. Get them all in there. Let me get done with this here. Now I got a gram of marsala here, and this stuff is potent, very, very fresh, so don't use too damn much. That's probably way, way too much on that spoon. About 10 pinches, all right? And I like it. The recipe don't really call for it, but it's really good in there. Garam masala is a combination of spices, actually. Curries and cloves, cinnamon. And we need some, what is this here? Coriander? Yeah, cumins. You can also put coriander in here. All them spices get to my nose. Some of that green shit in there, too. Damn it, boy. Let me whoop that together. Can you see down there? Now, I got a hunk of cubed cow. Gonna put it in there and mix all this together and form some little patties. Now I'm going to take a little small hunk and go stick it in my nuclear device, the microwave, to check it for seasoning. Make me a little small one like that, kind of flatten it out so it'll cook a little faster. So we can check that seasoning before we form the patties and put them in the fridge. For that Vulcan mind melt as those flavors come together. Because we want to let that sit for a bit. It's almost going to make like a sausage. It's very, very good. And that was ground cow I put in there. Yeah, 80-20 grand chuck. So here we go. Let's see what we got. Yum! That's perfect. Could use a tad more salt. Well, we could put that on the outside of the patties when we cook them. A little salt and pepper, and go grub them. Yum. So there it is. go put them in the cold, cold fridge and let them firm up. And I ain't gonna grill all of these. I'll probably freeze two of them. They freeze well raw, like they are now. And they're actually starting to cook right now with all those seasonings in there, and that's good. We want that. That's gonna permeate. It's like marinating from the inside out. I made a nice little salad, and you just grill these just like you do kebabs. And falafels are good, man. I mean, they got a, it's a vegetable chickpea dumpling, kind of like, you know, have it with pita bread. And see, you can make burgers and even meatballs out of kofta. Real good stuff. Now, let me warn y'all, Grand Marsala is a very potent spice. It's got a lot of essential oils in it. And I'll buy it in small quantities at Whole Foods in the bulk food section. But it's a lot cheaper like that, especially if you don't use it very often, because it can go bad quickly. So put it in like double Ziploc bags. They got the little small ones like this. Burp as much air out as you can. Then put it in a glass container and go put it in your fridge or your freezer. Okay? There you go. And it'll last you. It don't take much of that stuff, I'm telling you. While we're on the subject of spices, if you got any spice jars in your cabinet that's over a year old, they done lost so much of their flavor, it ain't funny. Throw them away. And next time, buy the expensive ones in bulk. Section, the way you can get as much as you need. In other words, if you only need a teaspoon, don't buy a damn jar that's got 20 teaspoons in it. Unless you're going to paste that on your nuclear submarine's control board for a directional finder.